St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King, a legacy of domination for 50 years. Go Fish Ontario, it's catching. This week from beautiful Camp Narrows on Rainy Lake in Fort Frances, Ontario. And I've heard so much about Rainy Lake, about the northern pike, the walleye, the big crappie, smallmouth bass, you name it, it's all here. I'm here because I want to inspire you, hopefully, to come here and experience the kind of fishing that I've read about, heard about, saw on the internet, saw on shows and stuff. And it's just a fish factory, seriously, with the amount of structure, the contour, the islands, there's always some place to fish here, out of the wind, to catch fish. So I'm here, it's first week of June, I've got the crew here, we've done a little tour of Northern Ontario, in the Sunset Country here, and coming to this place here, Camp Narrows, Tom and his crew have it so laid back, it's just like being at a friend's cottage for the weekend. That's his concept, his format, and trust me, it looks like it works, because these places are just full, and everyone's having a great time. So stick around, we're gonna go after some smallmouth, northern, and walleye, and hopefully we can have a great day so you can come here and have even a better day. Looks like that rock comes right out there. Right?
It's a bar.
Nice.
And then the rock down in there, you'll notice there's another one that comes out, and then there's shoal that goes between those two points.
Gotcha.
So we'll stop fishing. There we go.
Already. And it's a smallmouth. That did not take long, Scott.
Second cast.
Subsurface jerkbait.
Not a biggie, but a good way to start.
Yeah, it's a Rainy Lake smallmouth, right?
Yep. We'll get into a bunch of them. If we can get one early, we know we'll get more. Better go back.
Now, the first half of the show, I'm going to be fishing with Scott Hamilton, full-time guide over here at Camp Narrows. And like you said, there's so much good looking cover, but again, you got to be able to find fish, the better stuff. And lucky for me, fishing with him, I'll be fishing the better stuff, the good stuff, the money stuff. So we're going to fish smallmouth, walleye, pike. It's all here. You don't know what you're going to get on the topwater, subsurface, jig, grub, doesn't matter what you're using. Rainy Lake is where you want to be. Another great choice at these northern lodges are the KVD jerkbait. You can find fish fast on flats, edges, points, you name it. Jerk it, let it sit there, suspending, whatever you want to do. Sometimes I put a little split shot about 18 inches above and drag behind the boat with small twitches. Walleyes, northerns, and smallmouth, they all eat them.
Here he is.
Mr. Smallmouth. Just come off that bottom. Whoa! I seen him come up too, it was pretty cool.
Nice fish too.
Right off that bar, I think that's a nest right there, Scott.
It looks like it. That
ring right there.
Yep.
Yeah.
I agree.
Off that point. Deep. Let's see, he's spitting out all kinds of junk. Mr. Smallmouth bass, hold on. I'll let you go.
Crawfish and dragonfly nymphs.
My first Rainy Lake smallmouth. Mr. Smallmouth. Go on. Now, when you come up to a lodge, there's a couple lures you really got to consider, you know, because of baggage claims and different things and weight restrictions, etc. So the little curly-tail grub is one of the ones I would definitely suggest. 4-inch striking rage-tail grub, 3/16 and 1/4 ounce lead heads. We're only fishing anywhere between 8 to about 20-some feet of water, depending when you come. In late May, early June, July and August, those walleyes get off the reefs and stuff, but keep it simple, curly-tail grub. It will catch fish for you from northerns, walleye, and smallmouth. So it runs from that shoreline to that point?
That shoreline to that shoreline. There's some boulders and broken rock in there.
Nice.
This is might be a spot where you get walleyes too, because it'll be a little current through.
There goes one there.
There's a pike, I think.
Oh, and it's a big pike too. Wow. I've seen the shadow of that thing.
Did you?
Yeah, it's pretty long though.
I haven't seen her yet.
Yeah, it's pretty long.
Just a flash.
And I'm gonna have to help you here.
Okay, let's see if I can get her without a net. She's angry. All right. There we go. It is solid.
Oh, nice pike. Good one, dude. Look at the size of that thing.
Yeah, wanted that jerk bait, didn't she?
Yes, sir.
Let's get her beautiful back fish. In the water as
beautiful
quick.
Fish. Look how thick they are up here.
Yeah, wow. They're pretty, and they're they've always got nice clean lines and spots. They're pretty fish.
Yeah. You can hold her shot like this here with a mouth at her. Nice one, dude. Oh yeah. Open that gap.
She won't want to open up. She's got her hand clamped. Yeah.
Good stuff. Well, let's put her back and keep fishing, huh?
Yep. There's more of these. Lots of these guys.
Nice. Yeah, traditional pike splash, huh?
Got a fish splash for it.
Nice one, Scott.
Thanks.
Told ya. Pikey, smallmouth, walleye are coming, trust me. Well, we just started. Maybe 20 minutes. Rainy lake. Let's keep going.
Got him. Yeah. Excellent.
And it is.
It's a small off.
Good one too, I think.
Yep.
That's a fatty. That little small jaw.
It's a fatty.
It's got some girth to that one, isn't it?
Yep. Excellent.
Go.
Come here, girl. Right, like you said, with that hook, right? Oh, gone.
Gone?
Yep.
It's all right. You know what they say, right? It's all about the pursuit.
That's right.
Unless it's a giant.
It right in the top of her mouth, like you said.
Yes. We'll keep going. Look at the boulders and stuff here.
Yep.
See what all comes down like this? It's just smallmouth heaven and walleye and pike, but to me, that's smallmouth heaven. Tapering water from structure, contour. Rainy's got it all, man.
Oh, there's one right behind it. Look it. See it.
Got it.
There we go.
See how they follow that? That's amazing, isn't it?
Yep.
Good one, Scott. I watch him open his mouth. Isn't that something?
Yeah, wolfed it in.
Yeah.
They love these little hair jigs.
Yes. Good old hair jig.
But boy, I had to work her.
Yeah. She wanted it slow in front of her nose, huh?
Yep. There she goes. Perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, we weren't here very long. There we go. Nice little chunky one.
Yes.
There she goes.
And to think how many points you have on this lake. What, about a million?
Yeah.
The opportunities just don't stop on Rainy. Seriously. Even for first-time fishermen, right?
Yep. Oh, it's forgiving. Yes. When it comes to the first time fisherman.
Yeah.
Here you go. Pike.
Pikey. Oh, darn.
Well, there you go.
Yeah.
It's your.
L-Ikey. On my hair jig. Please don't have it too deep, I hope. You do too. Oh boy.
I can get it.
There he is back there, right behind the boat there. Tough little guy. There. I want my hair back, you little bugger.
Let's see.
If you can grab him, Scott, that'd be awesome.
I think
my line is Alfredo, oh boy. Where were they? Oh.
There we go. Handy duty. Thank you, sir.
Go.
Let's have a look inside. Okay. Fish is nice and healthy. Nothing wrong with her. And she'll swim away. That'll get me all wet.
Awesome. Thanks, Scott.
You're welcome.
Another bait you have to have, something that makes some noise on the surface. And for me, it's a little striking KVD splash. two sizes, the junior and the regular size. That's all you need. Pike, smallmouth, they just eat them up. Extreme Edge, presented by Strike King.
Hey guys, Bassmaster Elite Series Pro Matt Lee here, talking about one of my favorite Strike King baits. This is the 1.5 Deep Runner. It runs about 8 foot deep on normal 15 pound line. And a cool thing about this bait is the way it runs in the water. It's still got a smaller profile, so when you're not trying to make a really big profile in the water here on the lake we're on now, this bait works really good. It'll get down there, hunt. It's got a real narrow, tight wobble. I like using it for tough circumstances when the fish are really in a transition. And as far as colors go, this is a chartreuse shad, which is a little bit, it's a shad color, it's a little transparent. I like it when the water's really clear. When the water's a little bit dingier, I try to go with a shad color bait, like a sexy shad, gizzard shad, but keep your colors really simple. Have a couple for every condition. Couple things to keep in mind when you're throwing this 1.5 deep. The rod is real important, and I like this, a medium diving crankbait, dives to almost 10 feet. This is a 7 foot, medium heavy, 7 or 7.4, traditional medium diving crankbait. You wanna make long casts still, be kinda accurate with it, so you don't want a 7.10 or something like that. The reel speed is real important too. I like a medium to slow speed retrieve depending on the time of the year. If it's really cold out, I've noticed a lot of times you get bit moving the crankbait as slow as possible. Other times I like using just a medium retrieve just so I can speed up my fishing a little bit. A lot of times your bites will come right after you've deflected off a piece of cover. So if I'm reeling the bait along and I'm fishing a rocky bank or some wood or something and it's submerged, it's on the bottom, I don't even know it's there. I'll fish and I'll feel it bump something and I'll just kind of kill it. And a big thing to me when I'm cranking is to vary my retrieve. You know, I'm getting a reaction strike. So one thing I key on is changing my retrieve. So I'll reel the bait down and get it where it's bumping on the bottom. And then if I feel it knock something, I'll kill it for a second, maybe burn it, and just vary it throughout the day and see what the fish really want. If you're looking to catch more fish in that medium depth range, you know, we're talking 6 to 10 feet, try the 1.5 deep. It'll get down there, and it is a big bass killer.
Tom Pearson on Camp Narrows Lodge on Rainy Lake. Been here for 30 years now. Bought it when I was 21. We do all kinds of fishing and hunting, mostly smallmouth, lots of walleyes, lots of pike, deer hunts, bear hunts, duck hunts. At Camp Narrows here, we have 7 cabins. There's 42 beds total, so it's just a nice size resort, nice and relaxed. Great atmosphere, great views of the lake, as you see. The cabins go anywhere from 2 to 4 people. And then we have some that sleep 6 and some that sleep 8, just depending on what you like. Fully modern bathrooms. It's about the middle of May we start out. We have lots of smallmouth fishermen come at the beginning, go right through. Pike fishermen, it's great. You get monster pikes right away in the spring. Go through all through June. We end up at the end of October with crappie fishermen, some pike fishermen, lots of duck hunters. Then we go into the first week in November, so then we have deer hunters. There's lots of big whitetail around, so we do that. We do a little bit of bear hunting in August. There's kind of all, so no matter what you want to do, there's always something to do sometime of year. Middle of the summer, it's beautiful on the lake. Fishing is still really good, and you can just sit and relax. We get more families come up that time of year. The water's warmer, you can swim, you can do all kinds of stuff.
Another great option is a striking perfect plastic, and it's a swimming caffeine shad up here for the walleye, pike, and smallmouth. Something that attracts all three fish that you can catch all three fish on. This is the bait right here. You can cast it, swim it, hop it, jig it, it doesn't matter. From 5 feet of water to 30 feet. Slender body, little vibrating tail, walleye, northerns, and smallmouth on Rainy Lake. It's a good option. Oh yeah, good one too. Oh, big smallmouth, yeah, nice one. Good smallie. Oh, right on the side of that rock too. Tom has taken us to the money. Man, did he hit that like a gangbuster. Oh, he's got a big scar on him too. Nice.
Chunky.
Man, yeah. Oh, look at the scars on her, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Look at that fish. Now, she was jumped on this side too, eh?
Oh, yeah.
So something must have grabbed her like this, do you think? The teeth marks?
Yeah, sometimes they get bit up by pike because there's big pike all over.
Yeah.
Off all these rock points too.
We'll let her go. She can have some fun, huh? Ready? Ready? Go on. Wow. Rainy Lake is fun, dude. Man, oh man. You have got the life here, Tom. So tell me the truth, summertime evenings, you can just go almost anywhere and catch, right?
Any of these points. It's nice when the entire lake, everywhere you go, there's either boulder shoals everywhere, there's all these rock drop-offs, broken rock, sand, pencil weeds, cabbage weed, and it's endless. Miles and miles and miles.
How big is the lake again?
240,000 acres.
Wow. And it borders Ontario and Minnesota?
Yep. Yeah. And about, well, 75-80% is in Ontario, about 20%. So we're actually about probably 25 miles north of the border right now. And there's just thousands and thousands of islands. So
yes.
And every one of them has just this amazing structure everywhere you go.
Made for smallmouth.
Oh, yeah. Big one.
Oh, yeah. Good fish, Tom. This is the biggest one I got so far. So far.
Oh, yeah. There's a horse.
That's a Rainy Lake decent fish. That's look at the girth on these fish here. Son of a gun. Wow. Whoa, man. Whoa, Rainy Lake. Smallmouth bass, dudes.
What was that, first cast or second cast?
Probably first. So, yeah. Money man. Money spot. Money fish. See, like I am, get to fish with the owner and operator of the camp. Take me to his honey holes, as well as Scott. We'll let you go, big, beautiful fish. But that's why I came to the Rainy Lake, dudes.
That's a chunky monkey, that one.
Catch and release in June. Ready, big, beautiful girl? Huh? Ready? Go on. You made me a happy man.
That's what we're looking for.
You know what? I'm going to fight her towards the back, I think. I'll come back over here, maybe, Tom, on your side. Bring around this side.
Yeah, either way.
Just so I can see her. Yeah, I'll come around over here. Nice one. Thank you, sir.
That's a nice one. Beauty.
Rainy Lake. You got the chunk, smallmouth. Beautiful looking fish. Wow, man. I love this place. They have places for sale up here?
Oh, not too many.
That's what you get on Rainy, man. Camp Narrows, the place to come for everything. Ready, girl? Go on. Pike, smallmouth, and I guarantee you, before this show's over, Walters. All kinds of size. But a beautiful day in early June, feels like August. How can you beat it? Nobody fishing, just us. I'm in bass heaven. Now these little babies are a killer presentation up here in the North Country. I got it rigged. It's a little 4-inch caffeine shad. What I got it rigged on is a 3-odd wide gap hook with a bobber stop and a real small tour grade tungsten sinker. What the sinker does is help it fall. I'm gonna fish anywhere in that water column from about 4 feet to about 8-9 feet down. And on deep points and stuff, for smallmouth and pike and walleye, they see this, they eat this.
There's a fish.
Got him?
I got him.
Good one?
Yeah, it feels like a big one.
Nice, nice.
Something heavy? Oh yeah, it's a heavy one. I'm not sure yet. Nice walleye.
Big walleye, wow. Nice one, Tom. Wow.
Oh, get that baby in.
Oh. Oh, what a walleye. Wow. You got everything up here. Look at that mouth. Well, we'll take her out.
Get her back in the water.
Yes, sir. Those teeth.
Yeah. That filled the net.
Yes, sir. Wow. Beautiful walleye off that point, huh? Look at that. Wow. Yes, sir. Look at that. Beautiful. Good. Wow. Let's let her go, eh? How big do you think that is? 20?
Oh, it's in the high 20s.
Yeah.
There we go.
There we go. Get that hook down there. Watch just run your hand around there still.
Yeah, I got her there. See you next year.
Awesome fish, Tom. Wow, man. Northerns, walleyes, smallmouth. What's next? Rainy Lake, I'll tell you, Camp Narrows, it's got it all, man. You know, and just one day of fishing. Phenomenal. Visit Rainy Lake, the bass heaven, at Camp Narrows Lodge. Give Tom a call at 1-866-294-5067, campnarrows.com. Young Steels Ford Lincoln, Gamma Fishing Lines, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Interstate Batteries, Top Gun Marine, Rockwood LED. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.